Hello there. This video is going to look at the origin of some of the names of the Copperbelt towns. Unfortunately, there's been very little written literature, but thanks to the Nchanga Consolidated Copper Mines employee induction booklet, I managed to get some of the names of these Copperbelt towns. So where do we start? None other than my hometown, Mufulira. Mufulira is the original name. We've all seen the sign that says welcome to Mufulira. It says a place of abundance. Early 17th century, the place was full of blacksmiths, local blacksmiths, Bakafula. There was a lot of them. They were making these copper ingots. You remember these in our history. In fact, this symbol has always been there for a long time. It even represents one of the big banks. Yeah, so that's Bakafula, the local blacksmiths. They were in abundance. Mufulira stream was named, you know, from that because of the place of abundance. Now, in 1923, a prospector by the name of James Moyer, as he concluded his prospecting, you know, he was marking on the map, and instead of writing Mufulira, he wrote Mufulira. So that's how that name came about. So I guess it's going to be Mufulira Wanderers, Mufulira Trust School, Mufulira Swimming Club. The next town is Kuchitwe. Kitwe, you've seen the sign says the hub of the Copper Belt because it's right in the center of the Copper Belt. Pretty much all the other towns have a spoke from Kitwe, between 50 and 60 kilometers. History has it that somewhere near the Kitwe stream, there was a big blue elephant that had been killed there, so it had this massive head, Ichitwe. So even years on, that skull was still there. So people would say, I'm going in that direction. Ichitwe. And that's how the name Kitwe came about. Hadayama in the early 70s, I still recall, we used to laugh at him because he used to say, Nayaku Chitwe. So that was actually the correct way of pronouncing it. Arena Zimandona. There's Kandola Stream up in the Kaloko Hills, flows into the Kafue River and eventually ends up in the Kafue River. So that's where the name Ndola came from the Kandola Stream. That area, of course, the original settlers there from the early 1600s, the Lambas. If you remember your Yoruba Lunda migration, Chief Chiwala. This next one's quite simple, Kuchilabombwe, bullfrogs, croaking, there you go. Fibombwe. So kwaliba Fibombwe fidalila kuchirila bombwe. And Kalulushi. The place was abundant with rabbits to Kalulu. And the local hunters, you know, when they were hunting, they'll be in stealth mode and they'll be like shh. Whenever they saw a rabbit, they'll be like shh, Kalulu, shh, before they hunt the rabbit. So Kalulushi. Chingola is an easy one. There are a lot of zebras in the place. Obviously not there anymore. Zebras are in a Chingola. Chingola from the zebras at the time, Ifingola. So, Chingola. This was the only town with a gate. How did that happen? Luansha. The first one is that the place was abundant with dikers, insha. Antelopes, you know, dikas, so insha, luansha. Then there's a second version that says, you know, during the early settlers, there was a lot of malaria, and the settlers called it the Black Plague, and that the place was difficult. So ansha, difficult, luansha. So dikas and the Black Plague, take your pick. This is another easy one, Kuchibuluma. There were a lot of lions that used to roar, Kuchibuluma. So Kuchibuluma. Nchanga, Utuchanga, bush babies. They're obviously not there either, but there were a lot of bush babies in the area, so Utuchanga, Nchanga. Before 1964, it was known as Broken Hill, named after the Broken Hill mine in New South Wales, in Australia. Interestingly, the cradle of human history is also here, where, I'm not gonna call him Broken Hill Man, Kawe Man was discovered in 1921, 320,000 years old. That skull is still missing. Well, we know where it is. yeah, so in 1964, it was renamed Kawe. Akawe Kamukuba. Kuba is copper. So that's how Kawe got his name. Can we get the skull back? Can we get the skull back? And then our capital city, Lusaka. The early inhabitants there, the Solis, had their village where the present-day Manda Hill is. Again, different literature. Some say the village was called Lusaka. Others say the chief was called Lusaka. In 1902, when the Cape to Cairo railway line reached present-day Lusaka, it was renamed when Lusaka became the capital city of Northern Rhodesia to the current Lusaka with one A. So maybe we should go back to the original with two A's. This one I just put in for good measure, Mosiwatunya, the Victoria Falls, known by its less illustrious name, Mosiwatunya. And I was like, are you kidding me? This place thunders. So Mosiwatunya is Tokalea. I spoke to the kahuna himself just to confirm that, because there's been different versions of this. Those of you who have seen Ricky Longa's Mosiwatunya album from his early days when he had the Mosiwatunya group, that is Lozi. So that's why it's spelled M-U-S-I and then O and then Tunya. But the original is Mosiwatunya, the smoke that thunders. So the correct one is Mosiwatunya. And that's all I had on the origins of the names of some of our towns. Bye.